in Charlotte, North Carolina. Not a whole lot of skiing in North Carolina, but a little bit. Joining us here at the Skybox is the Tim Kaine, who is the former governor of the Commonwealth of Virginia. He's also the former chairman of this Democratic Party, and right now he's a candidate for the United States Senate. Governor Kaine, it's good to see you.
Judy, it's going to be great with all of you. Thanks.
So this convention tonight, Gwen and I were just saying, it feels like something you would see, in the middle of New York City or another big American city. It doesn't have the feel of a convention.
Well, it is, it's a little bit Charlotte. I mean, first, praise to Charlotte. I was the chair and chose it as a city because they were so excited to welcome everyone here. And they're doing a great job. And you have a wonderful feeling in the room. People know that the next 9 weeks are going to be real challenging, but there's a lot of excitement.
It should be said that Virginia is front and center on the floor, and that's not by accident.
It's not by accident. we were used to nosebleed seats 2004 and before, but 2008 and 12, we got pretty good seats.
That's what I mean. You have suddenly moved. You yourself, I think, have used the term checkmate to describe the role that Virginia plays in this process. Does that help you running for Senate, or is it kind of mixed blessing?
I think it helps. Look, first, I'm a Virginian before I'm a politician. We were irrelevant in presidential politics. And if you were a Democrat, Republican, or Independent, you were staying up to watch what happened in Ohio or Florida, and the candidates didn't come because why bother? But now that we're relevant, everybody in Virginia, DR and I, gets to see the candidates up close and personal. President Obama was in Charlottesville last week.
Over and over.
Right.
Congressman Ryan was in Richmond Friday. President was there in Norfolk again today. And everybody in Virginia now knows that they matter, which is really great.
The president won Virginia handily in 2008. It's a lot tougher this time. Why?
Well, look, it is. It's a challenging race. It's very close. It was a close race for him till the very end in Virginia in 2008. A lot of folks didn't think he could do it. And I think actually the president has shown in Virginia that he's got a pretty high floor for some interesting reasons. As you're wrestling, for example, with the deficit, one side would say deal with the deficit 100% through cuts, pledge allegiance to Grover Norquist, and then take out the meat ax. In Virginia, we're so connected to defense spending, and my wife works at the EPA and my brother's on a VA pension, that people realize we got to make cuts, we got to find savings, but you know what, we got to have balance too. And second, the president won Virginia by 6 points in 2008 when he was a neophyte running against a bona fide, iconic American war hero. Right. And now this president is a battle-tested wartime president running against a newcomer to the military or foreign relations stage. And that Virginia voter, 1 in 3 of us are directly connected to the military. The president's going to do a lot better among those voters in 2012 in Virginia than in 08.
You know, Democrats who get elected to the Senate from Virginia tend to be a pretty moderate bunch. Jim Webb, Mark Warner, they're moderate on guns, on social issues, pretty pro-business for those ex-urban counties.
Yep.
Is that the party we're seeing this week? Is it true in the Democratic Party, as it seems to be in the Republican Party, the moderates are a little out of step?
Well, when I made my pitch down on the stage a bit ago, I talked about Democrats, we're results people. You know, we do our best work when we let the other folks be the ideology people and we become the results people. And that's what brought Virginia Democrats from the wilderness back to, we've turned it from red to purple. And I think that at the national level, we've got to do the same thing. And so I was making my case, both for myself, but also for the president tonight, based on results. Big, thorny problems. How do we get out of Iraq? We did it. How do we get bin Laden? We did it. Let's draw down Afghanistan. Just today, there was an announcement in Virginia. It's amazing. For the first time in 10 years, none of the Virginia Guard units are deployed outside of Virginia. 15,000 guardsmen and women were deployed in the last 10 years, and they're all home today. And that's pretty important.
Governor Kaine, we've taken over. I'm sorry.